Dormet Dining. I'm Nicole Cormier, your registered dietitian. Here with me today is Shaylin, a BSc student.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Today we're going to be making morning breakfast cereals, which is very similar to your typical granola bar. And all of our ingredients are lined up in front of us. We are going to be using a little bit of tahini today, which this might be a new product or a new ingredient for some of you. All this tahini is ground sesame seeds. So it's just, and as we experienced today, once you open your can of tahini, you're gonna notice that all of the oil is separated and up towards the top of the can. And you do need to take a spoon and really mix it and stir it up until you get a nice smooth consistency before using in the recipe. Our next ingredient is our Teddy's, one of my favorite, peanut butter. I do choose the Teddy's with the flaxseed in it. Flaxseed is a really great anti-inflammatory. It helps add a little bit of protein and a little bit of fiber, and they also do have a chunky that we also found out today. Our next ingredient is any dried fruit. So at Trucchi's I decided to just go with, there's dried fruit that includes dates, raisins, cherries, pineapple, bananas. So it's just any dried fruit you can choose to add to your granola bar. We're gonna use some grapeseed oil. Grapeseed oil is great because it doesn't have a flavor to it, so it's not going to overpower the other flavors that we're looking to get from our granola bar. You could also use a coconut oil instead, which also has a lot of health benefits to it. It's coming from a plant. So our nuts are sweetener that we're going to use. So we don't have any sugar up here. Our really only sweetener that we're using is maple syrup. And maple syrup comes from a tree. So that's what we try to keep in mind, that it is also coming from a plant source. And we have some vanilla that we'll use today, and then a type of cereal called muesli. And muesli is just rolled oats mixed with dried fruit. So my favorite brand for muesli is Bob Red Mills. They do a really nice job with their dried fruit and oats. So we're gonna take one by one our ingredients, and we're gonna mix them into a microwave safe mixing bowl. And you can either put all of these ingredients in a saucepan over the stove and just cook on low heat until all of the ingredients are melted together, and just for a few minutes. You could also put it in a microwave safe dish that we're going to do today and just microwave for about 30 seconds to test it, to make sure that it's just a low heat and you're not cooking your oats. So we're gonna go ahead and start with our oats. Depending on how many granola bars you're doing, you can add more ingredients, but we're gonna start with about 2 cups today. Gonna go ahead and add our dried fruit. There's some pumpkin seeds in here as well.
So you'd add how much you would like to have fruit in there, so you won't have.
Yep.
To,
okay. The great thing about this recipe is you can start playing around with it. You can add different types of dried fruit. You can add different amounts of dried fruit. It's not your typical baking recipe where it's not the science of cooking. It has a lot of flexibility. As long as you have your maple syrup and your fat source from the grapeseed oil, you can really experiment and add all different types of ingredients. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and add 1/4 cup of maple syrup. A little bit of vanilla, about a tablespoon. Okay. And we're gonna do 2 tablespoons of grapeseed oil. Okay. The grapeseed oil is a great source of fat, monounsaturated, that actually helps you absorb the other vitamins and minerals from the ingredients, from the nuts, from the fruits. Fat-soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, and K, actually need fat in order to be absorbed. So adding fat to our granola bar is going to help you absorb those vitamins. Okay. 2 tablespoons of Trucchi Teddy's peanut butter. Always go natural with your peanut butter. You don't want hydrogenated oils in your peanut butter.
So it can either be Trucchi or regular peanut butter.
Yep, it could be the smooth, the Trucchi. And we're gonna do the same thing with our tahini. Just 1 big tablespoon here. Okay. And we're gonna go ahead and mix all of this up. And I'll give this over to you. You can finish mixing. After we mix it up, we're going to lay it flat on a baking sheet. We're not going to actually bake it, we're just going to use it to place and pat down our granola bar mixture and place it in the refrigerator for about 45 minutes. Yep, that's great. So you just want all of the oats and the mixture to be covered. So you'll be able to notice if there's any dry oats still left over. You definitely want all of the oats to be coated. Okay, so we'll dump this out right onto our baking sheet. And depending on the size of your baking sheet, we're actually going to use this portion of it. Just pat it down with any type of spatula.
That looks really good.
Once you start making your own granola bars, like I said, it doesn't take that long to make all of these, and it's a lot cheaper if you buy your ingredients from the store and make them yourself. You'll get more nutrition this way, and you'll get more value. Okay. You do, when you're pressing down, you want to make sure that it's nice and even. So by choosing to have a granola bar as a snack, you're actually having both protein and fiber, which really helps balance your blood sugars. Protein and fiber work together to slow your digestion and to slow the rate of the food turning into sugar in your blood. So when you have both protein and fiber together in your afternoon snack or mid-morning snack before or between your mealtime, you're actually balancing your blood sugars, your energy levels, and your hunger. Okay, and so we can put this aside, and we are ready to place our our morning breakfast bars, or aka granola bars, into the refrigerator for 45 minutes.